Knowing how to digitize my artworks using Photoshop or Procreate has completely revolutionized the way I work as an artist. Being able to erase the backgrounds of my paintings and isolating assets has opened so many possibilities. It has allowed me to transform my paintings into seamless patterns, create unique postcards, design custom prints, and even prepare my art for products like fabric, stationery, and home decor. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you the process that I go through when digitizing my artworks
using Photoshop
so that you can start doing the same and take your artworks to the next level.
And just so you know, I published a tutorial on how to digitize hand-painted assets using Procreate a few weeks ago. I'm going to leave a link below in case you want to check it out.
Make sure that you stick until the end of the video where I'm going to share 5 creative ideas for using your digitized artwork.
All right, so I've scanned these artworks that I was doing yesterday to complement a collection that I am doing inspired on the Mediterranean Sea. The other day when putting the collection together in Canva using this presentation that has been such a game changer, I thought that I wanted to make a second fish pattern. And so I decided to sit down and paint. And I spent a whole morning painting these fishes inspired on a video I made back in August in Portugal. And since I want to do a pattern with these fishes, I need to digitize them first using Photoshop. And then I thought, well, I'm just gonna do a tutorial on how to do this because I think people might be searching for new ways to digitizing stuff. Just so you know, I'm going to edit this video in the form of an art vlog where I share the process behind painting these fishes along other artworks that will go in this collection and other creative projects that I'm working on in my studio. One thing before I move on, if you're enjoying this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more creative content like this. And if you want to support me in creating more tutorials, get access to live drawing sessions, behind the scenes of how I license these patterns, and a printed physical postcard every month, consider joining me on Patreon. Okay, let's get on and learn how to digitize hand-painted artworks. The first step to digitize an artwork is to make a high quality scan or photograph. If you're gonna take a photo, you have to make sure that the lighting is even and then all those beautiful details are sharp and visible. It can be your phone camera or a more professional camera. Now, I don't like to photograph my artworks because I can get weird angles and shadows. Having said this, I advise you to scan your artworks instead of taking a photo. Not only you won't get any weird angles or shadows, but you will be able to control the resolution, which is key when digitizing your artworks. I usually scan my artworks at 300 dpi or at 600 if I want to use them in a larger scale. I like to save my files in a TIFF or PDF formats because they are lossless formats, which means that they won't deteriorate over time. Once you have scanned your image, open it in Photoshop. I'm going to show you how to fix the contrast and erase the background. So these are my scanned assets. The first thing that you should do before you start fixing your image is to duplicate your layer. At least this is what I like doing because if I do something that doesn't work, then I can go back to the original artwork. Now, we're going to go to Image, Adjustments and Levels. Alternatively, you can tap on the shortcut, which is Command L. And with this arrow on the right, you can control the bright area. See that if I move it to the left, then I'm getting rid of this paper texture. And if you move the right arrow to the right, then you can increase the contrast and dark areas. So you should judge when to stop. With this middle one, you can control the middle tones, which is also good. You know, I don't think I want this artwork to be so dark, so I can increase the dark areas, but still manage the middle tones with this middle arrow. So I think I'm gonna leave it there and tap on OK. This has already cleaned our image, and if this was to be an artwork to share on Instagram, for example, you know, this is good to go. Now, I want to show you how to erase the background. There are many ways of doing so. And in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to use the magic wand, which allows you to select pixels of the same color. The icon is this one here. If you can't see it, you have to tap and hold on these three arrows and search it, search for it here. And the shortcut, I love shortcuts, is W. You can also check the shortcuts and tutorials on how to use these tools by hovering the mouse over them, and then you will get the shortcut, the name of the tool, and a little tutorial on how to use it. So I'm going to tap on the white color, and you see that this now has selected all the background, which is white. I'm going to do this again. Tap on the white background, and there you go. You can see that this has selected some unwanted pixels that have been lying around. And what I tend to do to get rid of them is that I go to select, modify, expand. So this will expand the selection. I usually type on one or two pixels on this box, and this got rid of this stain. It expanded the selection one pixel, and that way it got rid of a lot of those dusty unwanted pixels. And then I can go back to select, modify, and contract to gain that pixel back. So that's, you know, that's pretty easy. If you want to check the selection further, you can tap on select and mask. Here under view, you have different options. Onion skin, you can't see anything. On black, you would have to probably increase the opacity. Down here, you can tap on invert. So that is the background which is selected and not the subjects. And here you can check that there are still some pixels lying around. And this has selected pretty well the borders. But if you want to soften this selection, you have these options down here. By increasing the smooth bar or pixels, you will smoothen your border. If you increase the number, the border will become smoother. But in my case, I don't want to lose this texture. So I'm going to leave this number in 5. No, actually, I'm going to leave it in 2. Because this will keep the neat border. The second option is feather, and if you increase this, then your border will become very blurry and undefined. It might work in some cases where your borders are in watercolor using soft shades or stuff like that, but in this case it doesn't, so I'm going to leave this number on 0. The third option is contrast, and it works very well when you have smoothened your borders and you want to bring the contrast back. Go ahead and play with these options to really understand what they do. Since I want to be able to use these fishes over a black background, I'm going to leave the contrast quite high. That's also why it's good to have this preview selection on black, because it becomes very clear how the borders are and if they work correctly or they don't. After you've modified your selection, you can tap on OK down here to exit this window. Okay, if I zoom in, I can see that there are certain areas like this tail that where the selection is not correct. So instead of erasing the background, I'm going to create a mask. To create a mask, you have to tap on this icon at the bottom of the layers panel. So I'm going to click on it, and this has created a mask. Now at the moment, I can see the background, but not the fishes, so I have to invert my mask. You need to make sure that the icon of the mask is selected, and then tap on Command I to invert it. It's difficult to see how well this selection is made with a transparent background, so I'm gonna grab like a very contrasting color, create a layer in between, and fill it up with that solid color. And that way I can see that there are areas which, you know, have some mistakes. So I'm going to tap on the mask icon, and with a brush, I'm going to paint on the mask to fix it. With the color black, you can remove areas from your mask, and then with the color white, you can add areas to your mask. This is called working in a non-destructive way, because even if you can't see the areas, they're still there. And with the brush, you can regain them. Now in here, it would be good to see what I have lost. So you can lower the opacity of the mask by double tapping on it and changing the density. which is the opacity of the mask. Now I can see the area that I want to gain back, and I just can paint on top of it and gain that tail. I can see this way if there's anything else that wasn't selected properly. I'm going to bring the mask's opacity to 100%. And in here, you can even change your shapes a little bit. I think that this fish, for example, has like the tail is too wide. So making sure I'm using the right brush, I can even like redraw. I'm using a Wacom, by the way. That's why it's easy to redraw. If you're using a mouse, then you might struggle a little bit more to paint directly on the mask. Oh, not so much. The good thing about the mask is that you're working on a non-destructive way. If I was erasing this directly on the fish and I want to recover it, the only way to do that is to press Command Z and undo this step. But by working on a mask, then it means that it's only a mask really what I'm modifying. And only when I'm happy 100% with the mask, I can go ahead and erase the background. This, for example, could be amended here. I really like having a contrasting color below my image because it helps me to decide quickly what areas I want to amend and what areas I'm happy with. Okay, I think I'm pretty happy with how this is looking. I'm going to duplicate this layer once more, right click on top of the mask and put apply layer mask. And now the background has been erased, which is great. Now I can go ahead and save this onto my image library. I can also turn this into a pattern, which is what I intend to do. Thanks for watching this far. As I promised, here are 5 exciting ways to use your digitized artworks. Create seamless patterns. Use your digitized artworks to create repeating patterns for fabrics, wallpaper, gift wrap, or digital backgrounds. If you want to learn how to create patterns in Procreate, I will leave a link to one of my Skillshare classes called Patterns in Procreate, Supercharge Your Workflow with an Image Library. You will not only learn a super easy and straightforward method to creating patterns in Procreate, but how to make them from reusable illustrations. If you want to learn how to make a full pattern collection, you can go check the tutorial that I'm going to leave at the end of this video. Design custom cards with Canva. Canva is a very easy to use tool that is perfect for turning your art into greeting cards or postcards. You can import your scanned artworks into Canva and play with the adjustment tools until you like something. You can also use the text tools to add a message or a quote to your design. Once you're done, you can print these artworks. Make stickers. After erasing the background of your artwork, you can create fun personalized stickers to decorate anything. Decorate digital content. Use your artwork to personalize social media posts, branding, or make animation. It is a great way to make your digital presence uniquely yours. Create art prints. Digitizing allows you to produce stunning prints to sell or make gifts. After refining the brightness and contrast of your designs, they can become fine art prints, postcards, or anything in between. Thanks so much for staying until the end of this video. I hope that you enjoyed it. If you did, please like and subscribe. And if you want to support me in creating more creative content like this, you can become one of my patrons. You will get access to exclusive content, behind the scenes, a live drawing session a month, and a printed postcard showcasing one of my many digitized artworks. And one more thing, if you like a tutorial on any of the specific subjects or ideas that I just gave you, let me know in the comments. I would love to hear your thoughts to make new tutorials. Goodbye, and I hope that you have an amazing day wherever you are. Ciao!